Hello, everybody. Scott Golden here with the WCW Saturday Night Review Series. We are moving towards the 19th of November, 1994. About a month, maybe a little more than that, before Starrcade. Our show, so a little bit shorter in our run here. Obviously, this is the kind of transition into the Hulk Hogan era of WCW. Hacksaw Jim Duggan up first, and that's why I mentioned the Hogan thing, because I think Duggan probably wouldn't have had a job in the era at the time if not for Hogan's involvement or suggestion. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe WCW would have found something for Hacksaw Jim Duggan to do, not for Hogan. Not that there's anything wrong with Jim Duggan. I've been on some shows with the guy, and had a good time with that several years ago. But anyway, Duggan, with some power moves against Chick Donovan, tassels included, by the way, on Donovan, which don't quite understand. Never saw Donovan in his prime. On the list of guys I'd love to see when he was doing more than enhancement work. Anyway, Duggan with the, I guess you'd say, spinning slam, and also hitting the running clothesline and the All Glory knee drop along the way. Duggan obviously gets the enhancement talent win. Pretty simple and direct to the point at the time. Then we see the continuation of Kevin Sullivan in an enhancement match. Of course, Sullivan at this time leading the Faces of Fear, Avalanche, aka Earthquake, and the Butcher, who is going to challenge Hulk Hogan in a couple of weeks for the WCW Heavyweight Championship. That, certainly, I can't say isn't a favorite Hulk Hogan. Anyway, headbutt by Sullivan. Sullivan with the tree of woe hits the running knee into the corner of his opponent, and ultimately hits the double stomp and gets the victory. Hogan talks about the betrayal of the friendship between he and Beefcake up next, and it's pretty basic boilerplate promo, nothing worth writing home about. We also get news that Jim Duggan and Vader will be facing off for the U.S. Championship at Starrcade. Of course, Duggan winning the championship from Steve Austin in the Super Bowl, or I'm sorry, Halloween Havoc time frame a couple of months before. Honky Tonk Man, another WWF cast off or throwaway at the time, makes a comeback. Of course, Honky Tonk Man had left WWF in 91 and done indies and international tours for the following several years before getting picked up with the Hogan Bunch in late 94. Honky Tonk Man hits a couple of knees on his enhancement talent adversary. Not exactly something to write home about. Also not a series of events that lots of people would be surprised by. Honky Tonk Man cuts the man off and is very basic with his offense, including the swinging neck breaker, the shake, rattle, and roll, and the victory for him. He goes into his main feud with Johnny B. Badd, which has been going on for a couple of months since coming into the area, over the television championship. Obviously, that very same feud is something that the Honky Tonk Man refuses because refuses to take a loss in, because he believes, rightfully so, that he will be relieved of his duties should he take the loss. Anyway, two-on-one match with the Avalanche, getting some punches, kicks, and body slams on two enhancement talents. Avalanche going towards matches with Sting and or Randy Savage intermittently over the next several months. That's the main focus there. Avalanche obviously hits the Earthquake Splash, 1-2-3 in the middle, and there we go. Obviously, the Three Faces of Fear trying to get rid of Hogan once and for all. Harlem Heat out for an enhancement match next, jumping sidekick and clotheslines by Booker T. Booker T, obviously, the more technical of the two. Stevie Ray is the guy that everybody is kind of looking at for power maneuvers. Harlem Hangover, 1-2-3 victory there, going into Starrcade, still warring with the Nasty Boys, as they had been for several months at this point. Arn Anderson and Bunkhouse Buck, a team up next, team that I never really understood. And Scorpio and Bagwell, Stars and Stripes, are the team here. Ming, aka Haku, is on the outside there. Simple match, not worth writing home about, not really worth watching. Patriot takes the majority of the beginning part of the match, holding on to the head for several minutes here. Anderson comes in and cuts the Patriot off, starts working over the back of the leg, hamstring area. Goes pretty aggressively at him. Anderson, to me, kind of, I don't know, maybe the Bunkhouse Buck thing just strikes me because I never got the gimmick. I actually like a lot of Golden's WCW work, but not nearly a fan of his WCW work with the Bunkhouse Buck character. Anyway, Anderson and Buck cut the ring off on the Patriot for the next several minutes. Bagwell finally comes back in and cleans house for the babyface team. But, I mean, literally, the entire story of the match really is the idea that Anderson and Buck cut the ring off on the Patriot for several minutes before finally getting handled once and for all here. Patriot finally rolls the man up, goes pretty aggressively in that, and again, the Three Faces of Fear promise to end Hulkamania come Starrcade, and the Clash of the Champions before that as well. So hopefully this is helpful. We'll be back with more right after this.